Hello friends, welcome to my channel Smart Learning Academy. In this video tutorial, I am going to discuss about the class 1 transposable elements, that is also known as retrotransposons. As I have been discussed in my previous video that retrotransposons can be present only in eukaryotes and in viruses. So let's discuss retrosomes present in the viruses. It works with the help of retrotransposition. The mechanism of action of retrotransposons is retrotransposition, and it works with copy and paste mechanism through RNA or mRNA. So let's discuss viral retrotransposons. This is the simple representation of viral retrotransposons. As I have discussed about the direct repeats, so the transposable elements or the coding gene present in between the direct repeats and LTR, that is long tandem repeats. These coding genes codes for the mRNA, and these mRNA codes for the reverse transcriptase, integrase and various enzymes. Let's see the example of our retrovirus, that is HIV. The HIV have 9 KB genome size, and it has 9 genes. 3 genes is present in all the retroviruses, that is GAG, POL and ENV. These 3 genes present in the all viruses. This GAG gene basically code for the capsid protein, matrix protein, or you can say nuclear protein. Basically it codes for the protein part. POL is basically for the reverse transcriptase, protease and integrase. ENV protein basically codes for the envelope and spikes protein. A very important enzyme carried by the retroviruses is which having 3 domains. One domain act as a reverse transcriptase, and one is RNase H that degrades the mRNA from the hybrid of RNA DNA, and third domain acts as a DNA polymerase. This diagram represents the overall mechanism of viral retrotransposition. So let's discuss, here is the retroviruses. The genome of HIV, that is single stranded RNA, is inserted into the host cell, and these RNA is reverse transcribed into the cDNA or RNA DNA hybrid with the help of reverse transcriptase of retrovirus. I told you the single enzyme acts as a 3 function, that is reverse transcriptase, RNase H and DNA polymerase. The first function is reverse transcriptase of that particular enzyme. Remember this series, first function is reverse transcriptase or reverse transcription of that particular enzyme. It reverse transcribed the genome of HIV, that is RNA, into the RNA-DNA hybrid. This RNA-DNA hybrid can be degraded, and only single-stranded DNA can be obtained with the help of RNase H, that particular enzyme. These single-stranded DNA can be polymerized and forms double-stranded DNA with the help of DNA polymerase. This is the third subunit of that particular enzyme present in the HIV. So remember these 3 functions in series, and these 3 functions is performed by the enzyme present in the retrovirus, not present in the host cell. Only various requirements like NTPs and tRNA is required and is consumed from the host cell, but the function of enzyme like reverse transcriptase, RNase H and DNA polymerase is performed by the enzyme present in the retrovirus. And these double-stranded DNA, this double-stranded DNA is basically present in the form of LTR, that is long terminal repeats, and the various direct repeats. These direct repeats or this DNA is integrated into the host genome. This integration can be of 3 types, as it is homology independent. That means it is homology, it doesn't require the homology sequence for the recombination or for the joining of that particular DNA, or it can be random, that it can integrate randomly into the genome at any place, or it can be integrated with the help of enzyme integrase. So after integration into the host genome, this DNA is transcribed into the mRNA, and this mRNA is spliced by various enzyme into three parts, that is 2Kb, 4Kb and 9Kb DNA. The 2Kb DNA is responsible for the formation of Rab protein, that is Rab, Rab protein. The 9Kb and 4Kb fragments have Rab response element, RRE, that is Rab response element. And this is 9Kb fragment is unspliced fragment, 4Kb is partially spliced and 2Kb is completely spliced fragment, which is responsible for carrying the 9Kb and 4Kb RNA outside the nucleus. So this 2Kb, the function of this 2Kb fragment is to carry the 9Kb and 4Kb fragments outside the nucleus. So this is the overall mechanism of retrotransposition in the HIV virus. So we have discussed about the viral retrotransposition. Now I am going to discuss about eukaryotic retrotransposable elements. In eukaryotic retrotransposable elements, I have discussed in my first video that it can be divided into two parts, that is line and sign. In line, the example of line is L1 elements. It is 6 to 7 KB in size, 70% of the total genome. Number of copies is generally present is 5 plaques in the genome and presently present in the euchromatin regions. The line is rich in AT and it is autonomous. That means it can work by itself. It doesn't require any particular sequence for their function. This is the particular gene which transcribed into the RNA and which is translated into the RNA binding protein, reverse transcriptase and endonuclease. These enzymes are factors responsible for the transposition, retrotransposition of line transposable elements. This is the transposable elements, line transposable elements. RNA polymerase 2 transcribes these transposable elements into the mRNA, and this mRNA is converted into the DNA with the help of reverse transcriptase. And this mRNA-DNA hybrid, or you can say it single standard DNA, is integrated to the target site. Let's discuss about the sign and elements. Sign elements is non-autonomous in nature, and the size of sign elements is very small in comparison to line, that is 100 to 300 base pair, and it is present 10% of total genome. Number of copies present is more than the line elements, that is in line elements the number of copies is about 5 lakhs and in sign elements it is about 10 lakhs. It is non-autonomous, as I have told you earlier, and the in sign elements the restriction site is present of ALU1, and the origin, the sign elements is the origin of synthesis of tRNA or 7S RNA, and it can show reverse transposition in presence of line. It cannot show reverse transposition in absence of line. That means the enzyme required for the functioning of transposable elements in retrotransposition is reverse transcriptase and endonuclease is basically provided by the line elements. These gene segments present in the line segment or line transposable elements, and these enzymes is required for the functioning of sign transposable elements. In the similar way, the transposable element sign can be transcribed into the mRNA with the help of RNA polymerase, and these mRNAs converted into the hybrid RNA-DNA hybrid with the help of reverse transcriptase, which is provided by the line transposable elements. And these RNA-DNA hybrid can be integrated to the site with the help of integrase or various enzymes. So this is the overall about class 1 transposition. Hope you like my video. Thank you for watching this video. If you like my video, please do like and subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.